Hey there, welcome back. Thanks for tuning in again. I am Josh with Impact, the host for this episode. And on this episode, I talk with Jason Palliser, the founder of 2-Day Blueprint, 27 ways to find new deals in your city or in any market that you're working. Guys, in this episode right here, Jason talks about a bunch of tactics that I had literally never even heard of before I met him. One of my favorites is called free mail. This is how he gets direct mail sent out for free. Another one is how he gets people to follow him in his website, on the browser, wherever he goes, using a tool called El Toro. So anyway, he drops a bunch in this episode that you probably haven't heard anywhere else. And he also runs this full 2-day boot camp to teach you all the tactics that he used to find distressed properties and off-market properties for hedge funds. So tune in, and after the episode, let me know your favorite tactic or tool that he uses and which one you want to hear more about. Drop it down below in the comments. All right, guys, thanks so much for tuning in. Hope you enjoy this episode.
Welcome to the Underground Live. Thank you so much for being here. Jason, can you tell us a little bit about what you do and how you're different? Because I know you are not doing the same shit as everyone else out here.
Yeah, so... Well, appreciate you having me. Yeah, so we do things a little bit differently. I've been in the space that every investor across the nation, you know, has been infused with the advent of the internet and Facebook. So where everybody does the same 5 1-out techniques, we do things vastly different. I've spoke for almost every real estate TV show there is. Robert Kiyosaki, Flipping San Diego, Flipping Boston, you name it. They hire me for lead generation process systems. Where we do things that are different to this is that everybody that does it, and tell me if it sounds familiar, folks. Get a high equity absentee owner list, and they're going to mail to it, and then postcard, letter. Then you do 2 postcards in a row. Just be consistent, and you'll close deals. Well, we wipe away that shit, and we show you 30 different ways that we get to off-market properties, and not just 5 or 6. And then we show you how to do it without a budget. So we've done it for big hedge funds, and we're in 138 cities. So I'm no smarter than anybody else, but when you give me big budgets and I have it down to a science at this point, because I get to track everything, I learn what to do and what not to do, if that makes sense.
Yeah, definitely. So let's just back up 1 minute. Yeah, just give us like a 60-second intro on basically what you do. Is it buy and hold? Is it wholesaling? What do you do, and where'd you start from?
Okay, so I started on the investment funding side, specialty funding side. And I got tired of walking away from closing, making 2 grand and seeing all these investors walk away with 40 or 50 grand. So I was like, screw this. And so I dipped my toes in the water, made some mistakes, and then started fine tuning my skill. But in today's world, we do about 80% wholesale, 10% fix and flip, 10% Airbnb. But I always celebrated the same thing. What we do is suffocate cities 30 different ways. And we just simply lay a blanket over a city and get to everything first. And then I get to choose what I want to do.
Oh, dude, I love that. Okay. And so you're out of your regular market at home was in Florida, but I heard you say St. Louis before.
Now, St. Louis is actually my primary market. I've been there the longest. Just moved to Florida approaching about 1.5 years ago. So we got deals going down here. But any given time, based upon some of the big institutional money and hedge funds that we put together blueprints for that we now do for individual investors now, at any given time, we're operating in anywhere from 30 to 50 cities. And when they hire us to come in, we can't miss a deal. So when we put together a blueprint, we do not miss. Like, there's easy deals as we're talking right now that everybody misses because they don't have things in place to grab the easy ones. So
when you're talking easy deals, what do you mean by that? What are we missing? What's everyone missing to?
As an example, I have a blueprint that'll be this weekend in about 48 hours. 10 or 11 investors from all over. So what I mean by that is this: there's 16, 17 real estate websites right now, just online real estate websites that we all should be on every single day, that if you saw this house in this zip code, and for those of you listening, in a zip code that you know, at this price, it's a no-brainer, you want it. The problem is you don't have any protocol in place to scrape and get those deals. And I'm just talking about low-hanging fruit, easy deals in these online real estate websites. So in the blueprint, we have 16 of them, and we put protocol in place that you don't miss those. Because here's why you don't do it. If you go there 5 days in a row on Estately, which half the listeners probably haven't ever been to Estately. You should. We just made 18 grand last month off Estately. But you don't ever go there, because if you go 5 days in a row and you don't get what you want, the job, you just, oh, it's a waste of my time. No, it's not. When there's 5 good deals a year and you don't know when they're coming, you should should have protocol in place to never miss those deals. So that's out of 30 different ways we do it. The first way that we teach you, and we just put all the protocol in place. Imagine a world where in 365 days, you never miss a deal. Just that alone is easily 20 closings a year for anybody listening.
So you're talking a lot of like automation on the back end then, right?
Yeah, some automation and then just some flat out different techniques that from a marketing standpoint that win, because we've tested some of the variations. We've tested out over 1,000 times. Some we've tested out 100+ times, like in the tax delinquent space. Any city we enter, any blueprint client like these that are coming to town this weekend, they will go back to their city and then literally just take over their tax delinquent market.
Get out of town. Okay. Look, since I've started this group, which hasn't been long, this is our, only our fourth live, so it's like the fourth or fifth week that the group has started. But I started it because of a personal pain point I had. When I first started out, I was like, how the hell do I generate my own leads besides direct mail? And dude, you seem to be 10X, honestly, where I'm at in the game. Like, why? And what I've provided for other people is just a vision. That's all I've shown is there's a way to go out there and do different things, right? I love lead generation, but it seems so hard for a lot of people. Most people are confused. They think direct mail or like maybe text or maybe cold call. Like, why do you think it's that hard? What are people seeing wrong?
So here's what people do. They get online on all these big Facebook groups and follow these Facebook gurus. And everybody just does some variation of the regurgitated, get this list, like get a, hey, use a Freedom of Information Act to get a water disconnect list. Duh, it's a good list. Out of 30 different ways, it's a top 7 or 8 list for us. And then they say, hey, start mailing letters saying I'm interested in your property or postcards. And then they wrap training around be consistent. So where everybody tries and they don't get what they want, or you get an appointment or two, but the seller isn't ready right now for whatever reason, which happens a lot. Shouldn't your machine be a lot better than that to bring in more leads? So what happens is everybody does the same 5 or 6 things and they never do anything outside the box because they just listen to what everybody else does. And again, when a big company hires me to do 1,000 homes, like one we did was in Houston, 1,000 homes in 72 months, that's kind of real pressure. And so we can't miss a deal, like I said, but they give big budgets for us to test everything. So we know how to win the pre-foreclosure battle in every city. Like not even remotely a fair fight. Tax delinquent, not a fair fight. Probate, not fair. How do we unlock water disconnects, cease and desist, code violations, but not do the same worn out, hey, I'm sophisticated because I went to this training and they said to do a voicemail drop, but people aren't closing deals. You haven't put together, the missing pieces are that there's a certain way to market and talk to that person to have them highly motivated to talk to you besides just getting somebody to half-heartedly go, oh, let me guess, you're one of those flippers. So some of the stuff that we do transcends that to where they want to talk to us so bad that literally it's like if your process is system and your marketing is good enough, it's like truth serum. It's not even fair. When they get on the phone with you, you don't have anxiety getting on the phone anymore. So we have like – we get the bone crushers as far as motivation goes.
Nice. That's incredible. Okay. So, I mean, I've heard you talk about before, this has always piqued my curiosity. You talk about free mail. Dude, you got to give me a little bit into this. What does this even mean? Are you getting someone to sponsor your mail?
So every investor that hears this, and they'll love your group and they'll stick in your group forever. So I'm not going to pull back the curtain fully. It took me 11 years to unlock that, but I will push you in the right direction. And then when we do blueprints, that's where we tweak things. So what I would tell you is this. You want to get your direct mail cost down. You may or may not have heard of it. And if you haven't, or if you have and you haven't done it yet, then as soon as you hear this, you should go do it. If you haven't heard of Every Door Direct, and I don't know, have you heard of Every Door Direct?
Yes.
Okay, so Every Door Direct has a relationship with the post office. And you can set up an Every Door Direct account. They've sent over 100 million marketing pieces out. They have it down to a science. They have people on the team, their team, that will actually create your marketing documents for you and your postcards and letters. And they know where to put things that you would never even pay attention to. So right out of the gate, your marketing's better and you haven't even sent anything out yet, right? But if you do good enough volume with them, you can get 6x9 large postcards and mailboxes for as little as 27, 28, 29 cents. That's less than the cost of a stamp, and they make your marketing piece for you, and they give you suggestions and do pretty much everything for you. And the cool part about it is with Every Door Direct, you can be like a sniper and choose the mail carrier and go to all these different places. So when we do a blueprint, we add two or three wrinkles to it that can get that cost basis down to zero. So yeah, so imagine a world where no matter what, no disrespect to anybody, but worn out technique that everybody's doing and saying on in Facebook land that everybody's like recreating the same thing. Even in those sandboxes you're playing in, imagine a world where not only you can be in that specialty list or high equity absentee owner, but what if we put together how to, I just told you how to drive your cost way down, but what if we get the cost basis zero and you can be in every freaking mailbox saying I'll pay cash for your house any condition. I just need 10 minutes to see it. Not a fair fight.
That sounds pretty good to me, man.
That's called
direct mail is just so expensive, right? And that's why I really started diving into lead gen myself, learning how to talk to people on the phone, learning how to optimize my appointments, learning how to pull their pain points out in 5 or 6 minutes on the phone. Because direct mail is just so fucking expensive. And when I was starting out, I couldn't afford just to scale that linearly. It just wasn't, the math wasn't working out for me. So that in short is like how I arrived and into like this mind frame and learning how to do some of this on my own. So it's a really good point you made.
Yeah, I mean, I like here, we've got, we closed out two. So we had 17 under contract as of last week. We just closed out two. The other ones are in their spots to close. But I mean, I'm speaking to you here from the RV, doing crazy stuff out in the middle of nowhere. So I'm speaking to you from my RV, which is my favorite place to work now. And I've never even camped in my life, but we can do this from our home. You can do direct mail a different way and get your cost down if you use Every Door Direct. We could show you on a blueprint how to get it down to zero. Now you have no heartburn. Now you'll never, would you ever stop mailing for free? No, you wouldn't. So that solves what everybody else is training and consistency. Well, that's already solved right there on the spot. So it's approaching it differently and having the right things in place to let your machine run like a monster and chew up the pavement.
That's beautiful. And so when you're talking about setting up a lot of these processes and a lot of these systems, what kind of back end in terms of human power do you need? Are you working with virtual assistants? You got butts in the seats at an office somewhere? Like how big of a team
do you
get this going?
Yeah, so we close 8 to 12 deals a month in my primary market of St. Louis. And again, 30 different ways, half the techniques that we would teach somebody are free. And so you can really start to suffocate your city overnight. So we spend anywhere from $700 all the way up to $2,500 a month to close 8 to 12, where my friends and competitors that try and close 10 deals a month in some of our primary markets spend 20 grand to 40 grand. That's what I call forcing your way into deals.
Yeah.
So team-wise, we have two people on our team in St. Louis to close that many deals. When we do a blueprint on day two, we open up. It's all built on a mind map, so no one has to remember anything. So it's not chapter one, take notes. That's baby stuff. These big companies, if I walked in and said chapter one, they would literally throw me out of my face. So it's all built out as an operational map. But on day two, where you talk about what you just said, how do you leverage this? So there's a section on day two that we crack open called leverage and scalability. So we're going to show you all the different levels of efficiency that we have in place for any one of our investors to do, whether they're brand new or whether they want to start approaching hedge fund level where they're closing 30 to 50 loans a month or deals a month and funding if they're keeping it because the big ones do rental portfolios. And we talk about virtual assistants. We talk about how you do interns. We talk about how when the internship is done, the last thing they do before you sign off their internship is they train their replacement. So now you have an internship that spins forever. People don't think about those things. I've learned logistics from people, and I spent good money educating myself, 120 grand post-college, get good at stuff. One of the best ones was logistics. It's these guys that do it for billion-dollar companies, and they're like, hey, have the spinning wheel, have human capital train their replacements. So if you're taking notes on this one, why would you not have an intern working for you, number one, because they need to do an internship before they graduate. That's leverage for you. But then their last item, if there's 20 hours left, just say, hey, if it takes you 3 hours, I'll pay you for the whole 20 hours. Just train your replacement. Now you have a spinning leverage wheel forever. So we teach you all the different levels of leverage. And I built and sold REI Black Book, real estate automation software company. So I built and sold that about 3.5 years ago. So we show you how to run this. When we build blueprints, we build it on free platforms, a Podio. And we show you how to run your tracking and systems for free. So half the techniques are free, running and tracking your systems free. leveraging several different ways that in the leverage and scalability tab so that literally you can take over a city.
Dude, that's really incredible. Okay. Here's one thing I wanted to ask you. You talk about the blueprint, and I know that's something, it's an education program that you got or an event, right? And you talked about spending money on education. Just for a minute about what goes on at the blueprint, just like a little bit more. And I have some specific questions about some niche-y things after that.
Yeah, that's fine. So as an example, this weekend. So we do eight to nine blueprints a year and for individuals. For 10 years, we didn't do it for individuals. We just did it for the big companies who need 500 or 1,000 homes. But once I sold our app Black Book and didn't get 200 emails a day anymore, I said to my team, hey, let's do it for individuals again so they can smash their cities. And so we do 8 or 9 a year. If we're busy, we limit it like this. Like we have a company that wants us to help them do 1,800 homes. So we're more busy this month. So I capped it at 7 or 8 people. So there's going to be 7 or 8 people coming in this weekend, maybe 10, because a couple people might be bringing a guest. And then we go up to 20 people. But what we do is for 2 days from 10 to 5, we literally go through a mind map that's taken 15 years to cultivate. It's got the knowledge and systems and process of 30,000+ off-market acquisitions in 138 cities. And equally as important, $60 million in knowledge and marketing budgets. So we walk them through each tab. There's a tab called the perfect day. We know in 138 cities what a very productive day looks like. Do this 18 times, should take you 4 minutes. By the way, good news, I don't trust you. Here's what we did for you. It's right here. Copy paste this in these areas and do this. Second thing you do this 25 times, 11 minutes. So we walk them through that. Then we go through 30 different ways that we generate off-market leads. Half the techniques are free. But then the last thing we do on day one is response rate. So we show them what we do first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth to get a response rate fast. The first 6 levels of attack cost less than $1. So if you're listening to this, stop thinking that this takes a large amount of capital just to get the machine running or compete, because that's not true. That's BS. And so then on day two, we teach negotiations and then leverage and scalability. And I've trained 42 acquisitions teams. I've taught negotiations for the state of Illinois. So we take the seller, what we call a seller waltz, the dance, and where most people say, hey, can I be the first person you call back because I'll pay cash and close fast? We say, hey, all you said to them was, hey, call me if you want to drop your number. Otherwise, don't bother me. So we teach you 10 different ways to turn a no into a yes that most investors will never know how to do. So lead generation, 30 ways to never have a lead problem, how to actually get them to respond without a bunch of money, and then how to negotiate on the back end. And then our team hands you the map, hands you the machine and tracking and the marketing portals, like plucking an apple from a tree. So there's no thinking involved.
Good. I love it. So here's one important question in terms of a cost per contract or cost per closing, however you measure that, and then your overall spread, right? Give me those numbers or approximate numbers on where you're at.
Okay. So one, I would tell you that one out of every 20 leads where we actually get them on the phone, I would tell you that, so one out of every 20 leads roughly we close. Our average spread last year on just the wholesale portion of our business, the ones we keep, we walk into equity and do whatever we want, right? But the ones that we wholesaled last year, we ended at roughly 23.8. And then the year before, 2018, we ended at 19.7. And half the people that are coming this weekend are like, dude, we heard your seller waltz gets bigger spreads. We break the seller down so that they actually see it themselves and actually talk themselves into why they really do need to sell. And that's an art form, but we get bigger spreads. And I always tell everybody, I'm like, you don't have to average $3,000, $4,000, or $5,000 a deal. Your spreads can be bigger if you do this right and get the better leads, right?
Definitely. Okay. Because at the end of the day, that's the most important thing, right? How much money you're going to make and how much money you're actually going to keep. So you can spend a lot and you can be really spinning your wheels and doing a lot of deals. But at the end of the day, if you're just grabbing a small spread and keeping hardly anything, what the hell does it matter? All right. Tell me a few things that you think are starting to work really well and a few things that are like falling off. So for me, for instance, I can tell now that a lot of direct to seller SMS, it's getting super, super, super competitive. And that's really starting to trend down for us in terms of connections per deal.
Yeah. So I'll just say to you this way. That's why I'm saying, guys, gals, we could show you how this really works. And what I mean is this, hey, you know, what's working, what's falling off. The thing is, you do not know. Think of that. It's kind of presumptuous. You're acting as if you're all knowing. Yeah, we do a lot of text messaging. Hey, we do love voicemail drops. What if that mode of hitting the person that you can make 50 to 70 grand on doesn't work for them? So you have to mix it up. So we know in each niche kind of what's working best. And it's because some people don't respond to direct mail. Some people will never respond to a text message. Some people don't even check their voicemails like me, except for every 5 or 6 days, right? So you using those techniques and then being frustrated and go, gosh, I'm spending money, time, and energy and not closing deals. So I would tell you that you have to do things that are a little bit outside the box and that are different. And I'll give one tip to everybody here. And as soon as I say this, I know mentally they'll take a step back and they'll be like, son of a bitch, you're right. Like, it's going to hurt. As an example, where everybody else, let's say we help you unlock 600 water disconnects, Josh. And you're like, okay, I got 600. Anybody that has to pee outside, you need to talk to them, right? Could be 50 grand every time the phone rings. Okay. So having said that, what do you taught to do? Voicemail drop, SMS, text message, postcard, letter, be consistent, postcard, letter, postcard. So what if out of that 600, you're 3 postcards deep and a couple text message drops and you're already $4 deep. That's where people start to get heartburn because they haven't closed the deal yet. You're already $4 deep on trying to get them to respond to you just like everybody else is. They already have 50 postcards. So one little wrinkle that we teach you to do things different, and if you do this right, you can do it without a budget and you start winning this game, is this. Inside the blueprint, we've tested 200 variations of door tags. 200 in multiple cities. We know which two win. So inside the blueprint, some of the easiest to-dos ever are waiting for you to win the game. So as an example, we will add as protocol, you or somebody's going to tag 600 doors and we're going to tag them. And I'm going to give everybody, here's a tip. One, it's the easiest and you'll use it for the next 10, 15 years and you will close deals and make money with no budget. You're going to walk into Office Max and say, hey, can I get a stamp made, an ink stamp made the size of a post-it note? And they're going to say yes. And as soon as they say yes, they're going to, what's it got to say? Say my phone number. And then it needs to say, hey, call me about your neighbor. And then you're going to grab every fucking post-it note in the store because you turned them into bombs and you're going to put it on their door. Now, Josh, what happens when you get home and there's a note on your door that says, hey, call me about your neighbor?
You're probably calling them.
Oh, you mean like I needed you to do so that I'm on the phone with them and not everybody else is sending voicemail drops and because they're sophisticated and text messages and postcard letter. I'm being consistent like my guru told me to do. So imagine a world where 18% of those door tags call you because it eats a hole in their soul. Who's talking? What neighbor's talking about me? So you disrupted their brain. They've already seen 1,000 postcards and didn't do what you wanted them to do. But now all of a sudden, and by the way, one, they're on the phone with you. You won the response game battle. Two, you did it for 1/10 and 1 cent. And three, you removed them from your marketing budget. Oh, and by the way, you could potentially make 50 grand off of that person on the phone. So if you do things differently, and again, I get to test everything with these big companies. So yeah, the people that are, I'm already getting text messages. Like the people, hey, we're on our way, man. We can't wait to see you on Friday. You're going to put together this. I can't wait for some of the techniques that reduced my budget. I had a guy last month, he goes, you cut my budget down by 60%. So that tip alone will get your phone to ring.
Get out of town. Okay. That's very cool, man. So in terms of like niches, a lot of people know the same stuff. You talk about water shut off and probates, but what are some other ones that you're going after that maybe other people aren't? Or give us a little bit of something there.
We really like, it's no secret. If you look up a hashtag 2-day blueprint and you see all over Facebook, different posts and stuff like that. I love tax delinquent. So I love delinquent tax. But most people just mentally exclude themselves. They're like, well, if I'm going to go after delinquent tax, that means I got to go to tax auction and compete well with all the big boys and girls. And I don't have a bunch of money, blah, blah, blah. We have techniques that you can rip the properties out from those investors that go to auction without even needing any money. So there's 4 distinct different things that we do inside the tax delinquent space. And I'll give a couple tips. One is that we come from a tax assistance program. We have a full-blown tax assistance program where people might qualify. They got to answer all these different questions. And when somebody calls wanting assistance, they spill their guts. where you got, hey, before you lose your house of tax sale, let me put some cash in your pocket. They have 50 of those. But when it says, hey, call us about and reference the code TAC424, tax code TAC424001, they call and go, hey, I'm calling about tax code TAC424001. Yeah, so if we approve you for funds within 48 hours, we'll shoot you an email with what we've awarded you to potentially help you out. Now I have their email in 60 seconds, which people never get their email because our approach is better. But the tax auction. So if your state has a redemption period, here's what we do. Everybody else goes to tax auction, bids on 123 Candy Lane. And let's say, Josh, you want it, I want it, everybody there wants it. And we wait an hour, and then 123 Candy Lane's up for 10 grand in back taxes. And we all start bidding. Let's say it's worth 100 grand as it sits. I bet 10 grand. You go 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. And let's say you win it at 40 grand at auction. One, you had to drop the auction. Two, you had to have 40 grand. Okay? And three, if there's a redemption period, like in Missouri, a one-year redemption period, now you have to wait to make sure that that homeowner doesn't pay their back taxes. You would get your 40 grand back plus a little bit of interest, right? But they can pay their 10 or 11 grand back and in back taxes and get the house back. So while all you investors do that, here's what we do, because this is just one of four techniques in the delinquent tax sandbox. Here's what we do. We sit back and we're like, oh, we have a little coffee. We let you guys play around at auction for an hour because we have that same list too, and we've already skip traced them. And I wait an hour, and then I look at my team and I'm like, go. And then we call them all. And here's what we say, Josh. Hey, look, this call might be out of the blue, Mr. Smith, but somebody thinks they stole your house at tax auction, and they're like, what the fuck? Who the hell are you? Look, I know I caught you off guard. I've talked to 10 other people today. We don't think this process is fair. 8 of the 10 didn't know either. And so what I'm saying is this. I know that this isn't fair. We have techniques to take this back. So if you'd like to get the property back, and we'll pay all tax liens and judgments and actually put some cash in your pocket, because right now you have zero, and it will help you do that. And the person that thinks they stole it from you at auction can screw off. Are you interested?
Dude, it's that tactical empathy you started with. I love that. I love the way that you just framed that.
And those listening, and here, this will solidify that this is your favorite niche and we can help you. Like, it's not even fair. We're light years ahead of everybody else. I'm talking about just one or two techniques inside the master techniques that we do. People are like, how do they not know they lost their house? When you're 1 year behind, you know it. When you're two behind, you know it. When you're three behind and the house needs work and you don't have the money to fix it and you're not paying your taxes, you kind of know it's going to get taken at some point. You stop looking at all that stuff and you move out because it's coming. Yeah. So they don't know. They don't know that in St. Louis that after 3 years behind, it gets slated for tax sale in August. So therefore, they don't know. So when you call them and say, hey, somebody thinks they stole it today, they are caught off guard. Like, what? And I'm like, we'd like to help you rip it back because we know the rules and we're interested in putting cash in your pocket and wiping away all liens and judgments. And a person that thinks they stole it can fuck off if you're interested. And they're like, I'm interested. And so what you got for 40 grand, we get for 10 grand plus 5 grand in their pocket. And by the way, if I sent a spy to auction and I know you bought it for 40, are you willing to not have to wait for a year and buy it for 45 right now? I bet you are.
Dude, that's
so I already have a built-in buyer.
That's really beautiful. Okay. Just a few more questions. We're only here for 2 more minutes, guys. I'm serious about keeping this to 30 minutes so we can all get back to our jobs and you can get back to skydiving. Tell me a little bit about if you're grabbing any properties on the MLS or is this 100% off market?
I would tell you that it's 99% off market. It's rare that we get something off the MLS. We do have other real estate websites that we hit because we put protocol in place that if it's this price and this zip code, we set the appointment. And imagine in 365 days, we never miss those on those 16 sites. That's easily 20 deals a year right there. No marketing budget, right? But most of them are, 98% of them are off market, 99% are off market properties.
Beautiful, okay. And are you doing this? My man Caleb on the line here is into multifamily a lot. Are you doing anything in the multifamily space?
Yeah, I have some guys coming this weekend that want to apply. So some of the things that we do on the blueprint translate to multifamily. So some of the techniques that I know you guys don't even know exist. Like there's things out there that I like searching for shoes and then shoes show up everywhere, right? What if you've never typed in a keystroke and I can be everywhere on every website, but you've never typed anything. So there's no way I could possibly follow you. What if I could do that?
Yeah.
So
are you using retargeting and stuff where people on other sites?
No. Retargeting means that somebody had to type something. They had to type in shoes, and then Google knows shoes or whatever, and now shoes fall. I'm talking about, let's say you didn't even have hands. You've never typed a keystroke, but you're behind on something, or you're a motivated person. I can show up on every website without you ever typing in a keystroke. That's nasty shit.
Get out of town. That's crazy.
For as little as 3 to 4 cents. That's what I'm saying. You don't need a budget to win this game. You need a plan of attack, 30 different ways to get leads, and then a real plan of attack.
Get out of town. All right. So, you know, I've heard you talk about this before, and I know this is an event. It's a paid event. But, you know, for me, self-education, paid education past college has been a game changer. So certainly myself, people on the line, other people that I hang with are no strangers of paying for education, specifically when the ROI is there. Like, what's the deal with you? How does everyone get involved? Or just give us a little bit about that before we go.
Okay, so yeah. So again, we only do 8 or 9 a year because we serve big clients. And we do as little as 5 clients up to 15 or 20. We keep it small because we actually build out everything for you and show you how this really works instead of just being consistent. And so all you have to do is go to the number2dayblueprint.com and schedule a call with us. We'll walk through what you're trying to do in your business, where you're at, and where you want to go. So it's the number2dayblueprint.com. And we charge 10 grand, 5 grand to schedule, 5 grand when people are always scared to talk price. I charge 50 grand for the exact same blueprint that these big companies that need 1,000 homes. And it's because I'm training 10 people in their office, right? The only difference between the person hearing it here is it might be them and a spouse or just them alone. And so what they get for 10 grand, other people pay 50 grand for. But we can help you finance a little bit of it if you want to help you get the ball rolling. But once we get our hands on you, it's over. Just the techniques that I talked about in this section here, I know people are going to run with. They're going to go crazy with it. Yep. But those are just beginner, like the stuff you heard, you're like, oh my God, that would work. I would call off of that. Well, then start doing it, right? But we'll show them how to suffocate their city 30 different ways and then give you ongoing help permanently. No extra costs in this at the end. All that guru stuff, we don't do that shit.
Good, I love it. All right, let me give you one more question, the best one yet. Give us one more gold nugget before we go. It's the last question. Give us one more gold nugget of just a website or technique that maybe people on the line haven't heard of before.
Okay, I'll give you a gold nugget, and it's a good one. It's kind of what I talked about, no keystrokes, and I can't even – this is the first time I'm ever going to give this. But I'll give it, but you guys won't know how to use it, so you better hit me up. Eltoro.com.
Eltoro.com.
You said give a good website, eltoro.com. Got that, Caleb, Josh, eltoro.com.
They do never heard of it.
Cookie-free IP targeting, mean no keystroke. You give them a motivated list, they scrub it, and with 98% accuracy, they can start serving ads to them with no keystrokes.
Get the flip out. Dude, that's incredible. Jason, thank you so much for all your time today, man. We've gone over the 30-minute mark, and I apologize for that, but you were just dropping so much info on everyone, so many gold nuggets there, and that is the goal here, to add values to everyone's business. Go check out his site, guys. I know I'm definitely going to, and I don't get a referral, nothing out of this, but I'm definitely going to. I've heard you on about 4 podcasts and just the wealth of knowledge that you have as a parent. So, man, when you pull back that curtain for 2 days, I would be like just blown away, I'm sure. But just to implement that stuff in my market here, I know the return on what I would spend with you is just an extra deal, right? 10 grand, it's an extra deal. So if I can get one deal out of it, game over.
Yeah, we destroy budgets. So what you're spending right now, why not spend it with monsters, right? And my team's gonna get heartburn when they watch this, that I said El Toro, they're gonna freak out.
Dude, I love it.
But we'll teach you how to get in the back door of El Toro, because if you call them, they're going to be like, hey, you need to spend 25 grand a month. And then everybody that listens will go, oh, I don't want to do that. But we'll teach you how to get in the back door so you don't have to do that.
No shit. Dude, that is gold right there. Well, guys, thank you so much for coming to the Underground Live today. It is over. So this elevator is going up. See you next time.
Bye.
Bye-bye.